Köszönöm elnök úr, hogy lehetőséget adott, hogy találkozunk.
Thank you, Mr. President, for making this meeting possible.
Well, nagy élmény volt nekem ez a pár nap, amit itt töltöttem, és most itt lehetek lenni.
That I have spent here a marvelous experience. I'm very pleased to be here with you this morning.
Well, I'm pleased to have you.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for having
me. Thank you for having
me. And sit down.
Yeah,
we'll put the chairs down for interpreters after the photo op. We have three ways of press that we have.
Hát ennek itt már megvan a történelmi hagyománya.
Well, you have historic traditions regarding this.
Yes.
The fireplaces are world famous as a result.
That's George Washington.
Rendkívül nagy forgalmat, külföldi forgalmat bonyolít.
Mr. President, there's a tremendous international traffic that goes through this room, this office.
Yes.
Igen, ez így van.
Getting Noriega out, or are you resigned to the fact that he's going to be staying there long after you even leave office?
Now, I have to tell you, I've seen all these things in the paper, and all I have to say is this is something I can't talk about.
No, I didn't ask you about the intelligence finding. I'm just wondering whether you really think there's any way of getting him out of there.
Well, again, I shouldn't be commenting on that. Certainly he is not good for Panama or good for our relations.
But he seems to have beaten you back. The sanctions aren't working. They're hurting the people more than the Noriega regime.
Well, as I say, I
but
can't.
Did you sign the secret?
Is there anything else you
directive
can do?
Directive to depose him?
I'm not going to comment on anything that will of the nature of covert operations.
You can deny it
because
it was
revealed. Thank you.
Are you angry at Congress for leaking all this stuff?
I'm usually angry at Congress, yes.
Do you think that this proves that you shouldn't tell them about intelligence and covert actions?
I think there are some improvements that could be made with regard to the restrictions that have been placed on the presidency of these 2 years.
Thank you. We have another group of press together.
Cameras, please, take it away.
Maybe Abrams leaked it.
Let's go, please.
Maybe you leaked it to scare Noriega. Maybe the administration will be scared Noriega.
Andrea, there's another group of press waiting outside who you're keeping.
Come on, Andrea.
You don't want to keep your colleagues waiting, do you?
Disinformation.
Another group of press to get in.
I know.
Speak up.
I'm waiting.
Okay,
so
let's go, please, Andrea. Thank you.
Cameron, this way, NBC.
Thank you.
Nagyon tiszteljük a hölgyet.
Mr.
President, a question from the Hungarian television. What do you think could be the role of Hungary in the future of the East-West relationship?
Well, I think Hungary should play an important role and is playing an important role. Those are things we'll be talking about.
What is your impression about the policy of our Prime Minister until now? The economic policy and everything that you heard before he came here.
Well, I approve very much of what I've heard and the plans that he has. I look forward to having him there.
Thank you. Nice, thank you.
Okay.
General Secretary, your visit marks a decade of progress in our relations, beginning with the return of the crown of St. Stephen to Hungary, and we hope for even closer ties in the years ahead. Your recent party conference and reforms have received much attention in the West, and we're impressed by your willingness to accept new ideas and your commitment to implementing major reforms. Measures to open the Hungarian economy to private sector activity should provide a sound basis for economic growth. And we also welcome your decision to implement an IMF stabilization and reform program. You can become a great leader by making your country prosperous. To be successful, economic reform must be coupled with political reform. A greater role for parliament and greater tolerance for dissent would be positive first steps. And we hope you'll continue to move toward greater economic and political freedom. Now, I know our others here would be interested in hearing how you plan to develop Hungarian reform and what your next major steps will be.
Mindenek előtt szeretnék őszintén köszönetet mondani ennek és a kormánynak a meghívásért. 42 esztendő telt el azóta, hogy magyar miniszterelnök hivatalosan az Egyesült Államokba látott. 1946-ban, amikor itt voltam első magyar miniszterelnök, akkor a békeszerződésről folyt tárgyalás. ma pedig az a célunk, hogy évtizedes tapasztalat, amelynek szolgálatában én dolgozom. Ez mostani látogatásunknak alapvető célja, hogy megismerkedjünk, hogy hogyan vélekednek ezek a világról, milyen terveik vannak, és hogyan, és miképpen képzelik el az emberiség együttműködésének útját.
Another cooking.
And not
my mic's like a marvelous.
az egyik ország miniszterelnöke, már nem tudom, hogy ki, nagyon fel volt háborodva, hogy a Thatcher hölgy hogy intézte a dolgokat, hogy vezette az ülést.
Suddenly he erupted and he told her she wasn't being democratic and running the meeting the way she was running it.
Hirtelen kirobbant, és azt mondta, hogy a hölgy nem volt eléggé demokratikus, ahogy ő intézte, a vezette az ülést.
He really stormed there for a while.
Az ülésnek vége volt,
hogy
az utána oda mentem hozzá, és azt mondtam, Margaret,
women know when men are being challenged.
Ő erre azt mondta, a hölgyek mindig tudják, hogy az emberek, hogy a férfiak mikor gyerekesek.
Szellemes.